Hey, what's up everybody? I wanted to do a video talking about the recent Firefight update that's come out for Halo 5. I've been playing a lot of this since it came out, and it's really... I mean, I wasn't getting bored of Halo 5 at all, but this has really just kind of... really reinvigorated my enjoyment of the game, to be honest. As I said, it wasn't getting stale or anything, but I think this is really... given the game a hell of a lot of longevity. This gameplay right here is one that unfortunately I lost the first bit of it, which is unfortunate because it was actually a pretty good game. But I wanted to do a video and talk about the complaints that have come out about it. Much like anything, you know, if anything comes out for this game, people complain about it. And Firefight is no exception. And the amount of complaining that's been done about Firefight is pretty substantial. I'm mainly referring to just the Waypoint forums. That I've recently begun posting on. I've been, you know, lurking on there for a while, but recently started posting. And there's just been so much complaining about this mode that it really just... some of it really needs addressing and clearing up, in my opinion. I'm not a big, you know, Halo streamer or video maker, but this is my two cents. So, there we go. So, I've got five main points here that I think are the biggest ones. The first one is overall difficulty. Granted, since it's come out, this one actually has died down a little bit. People aren't, you know, complaining as much about this one. And I think the reason people were complaining about this so much early on is because it was new. I think a lot of people were expecting to jump into Firefight and have it be like, you know, Reach and ODST. Which was easy, you know, that's another thing as well. Firefight in those games, you know, it wasn't a question of if you'll finish it, it's when you'll finish it. It wasn't hard at all. But it was still fun. That's definitely gone away now, and I think that was, again, you know, heat of the moment. You know, people jumping into it and expecting to be able to do it, you know, first time. That's an unrealistic expectation, and it shouldn't be that way either, because that'd be too easy and it'd be boring. You know, it'd be a boring mode. This is the last, you know, big update, at least for the, you know, foreseeable future, that we're getting. You know, did people really want it to be something they could just steamroll in like 2 days and figure out completely? I didn't, and I was glad it wasn't. When I first played it, I was actually really happy that it was hard. I think it took me about 2 or 3 games before I got a win. You know, I was really happy that it was difficult. So I think that one's kind of died down, but that one again is just, you know, people's unwillingness to want to learn and actually figure stuff out. Now that I've played it a lot, you know, I've got a pretty good idea of what all the enemy patterns are, so you know where to set up, you know what vehicles to use, you know what weapons to use, you know what you should be doing. I think that was just a real classic case of, you know, just jumping the gun. You know, it was hard at first, and, you know, it's not as bad now. So the next one, this kind of goes hand in hand, I think. It's the wreck level speed and the dependency on high level wrecks. I think the wreck level speed, the speed at which you actually, you know, gain wreck levels is fine. The one thing where I actually kind of do agree with this is I think the wreck recharge speed should be faster. At certain points in the game, you know, if, for example, like later in the rounds, like round 4 or 5, for example, if you spawn a tank early on in those rounds, it's going to take you like the vast majority of that round to be able to spawn another tank. And if that's round 5, essentially you're screwed because you can't get another one in time to help your team. And, you know, vice versa, if it happens in 4, that's going to be another tank you're going to have to use. So you need a lot of tanks. That's another thing about this game mode that, you know, right up front, you need a lot of tanks if you want to win. You really do need tanks for this game mode. That's pretty much it. It's tank still wins. But the wreck dependency, again, there is some merit to that, especially if you're a new player. You know, I've been playing the game for a while now, so, you know, I've got a fair amount of the really, really high level wrecks unlocked. You know, I have, you know, the high level tanks. I have the high level power weapons. My argument for this kind of against it, though, is that, you know, again, if these weren't required, if you could just steamroll through the game with, you know, load out weapons, would that really be fun? Like, would anybody really enjoy that? Like, I wouldn't really. It's just, that'd just be a shooting gallery, and if I wanted that, I'd go and play Reach's Firefight. And that's not a knock on Reach's Firefight. I loved Reach's Firefight, but, you know, I'm glad that this is a different mode. So, you know, that's something else as well. The other one, another big complaint is the bullet sponging enemies. This one, again, this could do with a little toning down, I gotta admit. Some of them are okay. Like, I don't really think all of them are really bad. Like, for example, the grunt boss, I think, is an example of one that is a little bit over the top. This one right here that you're actually seeing, funnily enough, I think he's like the highest level of the grunt mech. The ones below him are okay. Like, I think the ones below him are where it should be. You know, if you've got, say, a tank and, you know, a few guys concentrating fire, you can take those other ones out relatively quickly. This guy, however, you know, you need a tank, basically. You need a tank, you're probably going to need more than one tank. And with how quickly he can destroy you, you know, even if you're in a vehicle, I do think the bullet sponge aspect of some of them could do with toning down. Mythic Wardens is, I think, the main one, to be honest. I don't think, I would rather have Mythic Wardens have a little bit less health. I'm not talking something crazy, like, you know, half their health or something. I'm just think, you know, maybe 20% less health on those Mythic Wardens. To have, like, four guys just wail away on them with tanks for, like, a minute straight to kill them, like, that is a bit much. You know, that's a bit much. Or have something in there where you could actually do damage without, you know, the higher level wrecks. One thing I heard, it was actually on, I think, Luke the Notable's video about Firefight. I thought it was a really good idea. I'm not sure if it was his idea, but it was a really good idea. And have their health linked to, like, all the Prometheans or the enemies in the game. So, for example, if you're, you know, a relatively new player and you can't spawn in a tank, you could, you know, just spawn in, you know, two loadout battle rifles and just keep picking off the little enemies, you know, bit by bit. You know, you might not be dealing a lot of damage, but you're at least taking a little bit off the Warden, and you can, you know, help your team that way. The last one, I think, is Certain Encounters. I've seen a lot of them being thrown around. There's very, very few that I actually think are just downright unfair. I think the Warden round 3 on Apex, I think, is one. And funnily enough, I don't think it's actually the Wardens that make that hard. I think it's the, like, 8 billion knights that spawn in front of them all with incineration cannons that make it hard. That round at the start, it should say kill the knights, not the Wardens, because the Wardens aren't the problem in that round. Yeah, I think they're only regular or, like, level 2 Wardens. There's that one. There's the two grunt mech on, I think it's... what's that? I think it's Stormbreak, the map with the the snow, you know, the snow level map. I think it's called Stormbreak. That's another one. If one of those grunt mechs gets on the lower level, like where the Banshee spawns in regular Warzone, it's almost impossible to kill him because you cannot get tank rounds down there to hit him. So, you know, he's just down there, you know, and all you've got is regular weapons, in which case you are completely screwed. Like, they have way too much health to be taken out with just regular loadout weapons. And that's mainly the ones that I've seen so far. The main thing I want to talk about to wrap up is how a lot of this can be addressed. And a lot of it, honestly, is just people play this mode horribly from what I've seen. People rarely cooperate. People very, very rarely communicate. There's been a couple of times where I've died with a really, really good power weapon, and I've called out that it's out. You know, I've said, guys, you know, there's an X weapon where I just died. Go and pick it up. You know, nobody goes to pick it up. Nobody tries to coordinate. I think a lot of people, even though this is a co-op mode, a lot of people play it like a lone wolf, and all people are interested in is getting, you know, the highest kills, being the highest person on the board. That's not the aim of the game. You know, the aim of this mode is to win all 5 rounds. If you fail at round 4 and you're top of the board, congrats, you still lost. You know, you still didn't win. You might have been top of the board, but you still didn't win. This bit coming up is really cool, by the way. But yeah, so that's the main thing as well. The other thing is kind of a knock-on effect of that is strategy. You know, a lot of the time you see people just do really, really dumb shit in this mode. The Warden fight I was on about just now, I've yet to have a game where people actually play that round how you should. Most of the time, people just rush, you know, the knights, and, you know, you are literally rushing about 20 knights if you do that. Even with a tank, you know, even with, like, something like an Oni Scorpion or something, you are going to die. That's not going to work. You have to hang back, you know, pick them off, and then tackle the Wardens. I've yet to have a team that does that. You know, they all just rush them with shitty weapons and get killed, and then complain that you can't beat the stage. And, you know, I think, well, yeah, of course you can't beat it. You're not playing it right. You know, you're playing like an absolute idiot. I was really surprised this combination, by the way, wasn't more powerful. This is what I kind of mean about, like, some enemies could maybe use a bit of a tone down. That one was pretty weak. I think this one's brand new. Like, that was two hammer hits with a damage boost. I mean, that did nothing. He didn't even care, and he just bitch slapped me, which is pretty funny, but still. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. I think a lot of people just... If you want to skip to the end, I'll put it in the description. Skip to 10 minutes 30. Play smarter, don't be an idiot, communicate with your team, and don't be afraid to spend Rex, and you'll start winning a lot more games in Firefight. You know, if you don't want to do any of those things, then don't play this mode. It's not for you. Don't complain that it's too hard because you are too stubborn to adapt to it and actually play it properly. So that does it for this video, guys. Peace. I'll catch you later.